To the Senate, where the vote is underway on final passage of the Murray-Ryan budget. Some of the 12 Republicans who voted to let the bill move forward are expected to oppose it now. 51 votes are needed for passage, which it is expected to get. Ahead of this vote, did you hear about this one? Last night, Senate Democrats voted to block an amendment that would have allowed military veterans to keep their benefits by taking away tax credits for illegal immigrants. The vote was largely along party lines. And this former Republican congressman says the Democrats are out of line. Alan West is a retired Army Lieutenant Colonel. Sir, welcome back to the program. Good to see you again.
Good to be with you, Stuart, and Merry Christmas.
And Merry Christmas to you, sir. Will anybody pay a political price for this dissing of vets?
Well, they absolutely will pay a political price, and it's just not veterans. What you're really talking about are military retirees, and those are individuals that have served a minimum of 20 years or more in service to the United States of America, Army, Navy, Air Force, Marines, and Coast Guardsmen as well. But then you're also talking about those individuals that have been medically retired because of the injuries and wounds that they received in combat, being in Iraq, Afghanistan, Vietnam, or previously. If you are under that 62 years of age, and that means me. The 22 years that I served, I just found out that my retirement benefits are going to be cut. Some people will say it's just a 1% cost of living allowance cut, but over the time, it can be anywhere from $120,000 to $140,000 for a lieutenant colonel, and anywhere from about $77,000 to $82,000 for a staff sergeant or sergeant first class. So this is a very huge impact, but it's a break of trust. That's the biggest point.
Now, these cuts were part of the Ryan Murray bill. Here's what Democrat Senator Patty Murray has to say about military veterans losing their benefits in the budget deal. Here's what she says.
I want to make absolutely sure today that they know that a provision included in this deal that mistakenly included disabled retirees and survivors for changes in the pension growth will be addressed in short order following passage of this bill.
Now, she is saying, I don't know whether you could hear that, Colonel, but she is saying that that was an error where it concerns wounded warriors and it will be corrected. Are you happy and satisfied with that?
No, I'm not. I mean, because the point is that don't tell me that you're going to pass it in the Senate, you're going to have it signed into law, and you're going to come back and fix it. That's a lie, and she knows it's a lie. The bottom line is that that should have never been part of it. And we're talking about $6 billion, Stuart. You know, we're printing $85 billion a month. Senator Tom Coburn just came out yesterday with his wasteful spending in government book, and that's $33 billion. So, you know, what are they trying to say that and when you block the amendment for those tax credits that go into illegal aliens, who are more important, the illegal aliens or people that have served 20-plus years and, you know, have service disabilities?
It's a fair point, Colonel. I'm going to play the other side of the fence for just one moment. There is a deal. It's passed the House, probably going to pass the Senate. It is a deal. That gives a degree of stability, and it means that there will not be a government shutdown next month because there's no budget deal. That you're saying it's not worth it, that stability and no shutdown is not worth this dissing, if I can put it like that, of military vets.
It's not dissing, it's disrespect, it's dishonorable, it's a breaking of trust to those of us that raised our right hand and were told that you served 20 years plus, the United States government is going to take care of you. And we, in full faith and credit, we went out and did what we were supposed to do, standing on freedom's ramparts. Now, you're going to come back and tell me that all the wasteful spending in Washington, D.C., you cannot find $6 billion. You're going to tell me you blocked an amendment to get rid of tax credits for illegal aliens, but you continue to want to take $6 billion from those of us who are willing to give the last full measure of devotion. This is not about a government shutdown. This is about doing what is right by people.